Welcome to Oblasawa, Detective. Yesterday, a mysterious floating island we believed to be the legendary Sky Kingdom suddenly appeared from beyond the clouds. But as soon as it emerged, crumbling pieces of the island hurtled to the ground below. A number of citizens have already been gravely hurt. Further destruction must be prevented. Seek out a fortune hunter called Jack. Rumor has it that he once managed to set foot in the Sky Kingdom. He may be able to provide guidance through the fabled kingdom. But a word of warning. A village girl saw a sinister-looking man emerging from a crater. We believe he may be a threat to your mission. Good luck, Detective.
Leave now, stranger, or suffer the consequences. Intruder! Our king's treasure is not for you to take. Your journey ends here.
The Bean of Eternity will grant long life. The Bean of Invisibility will allow a person to be concealed from sight. The Bean of Growth.
Call it a strategic retreat. Yeah.
What did you do to my friends? Are they still alive?
Hello, Detective. The name's Jack. We don't have much time for pleasantries, I'm afraid. The Sky Kingdom is falling apart as we speak. Quick, open the treasure chest. What's inside can put a stop to all this. It's a magical secret of the Sky Kingdom. Once you get the treasure, meet me by the bridge. Don't worry about the prince. I'll take care of him. Trust me. The prince is off on a wild goose chase. He won't be bothering us for a while. Come on, detective. It's time to grow us a magic beanstalk. Take the key. We'll need it in the Sky Kingdom. To get to the Sky Kingdom, we're going to need magic beans. This isn't right. We need magic beans.
My darling Jack, your desire to reach the Sky Kingdom has become an obsession. You don't sleep. You don't eat, and you refuse to give up. Seeing you so haunted makes my heart break. Take these beans and go achieve your dreams. And afterwards, we can finally start our life together. Love, Emma.
People in the picture, they were my team, my friends. 10 years ago, we planned a heist on Sky Kingdom, and everything seemed to be going well, but the three princes appeared. They attacked. I was the only one who managed to escape. My friends, my fiance, Emma, they were trapped in the Sky Kingdom. Detective, there's only a slim chance that my friends are still alive, but I have to try. Please, take me with you to the Sky Kingdom. Good. You have the beans. Once they're planted, we'll be able to reach the Sky Kingdom.
Look out!
Detective. I'm going to need your help getting out. Here, take this. You'll need it inside my cottage.
Thank you.
Ring. Detective, I'm in too much pain to move. Can you get a healing potion from my cottage? Much better now. Let's head on to the Sky Kingdom before the Prince comes back.
You will not set foot in our kingdom again.
Go!
Are you the Fairytale Detective? I'm glad you're finally here, Detective. But the Sky Kingdom does not welcome trespassers. You should probably look in Prince Hugh's room over there if you want to stop the Sky Kingdom from falling. Be careful of the princes. If they see you, they'll have your head. I have to go. Good luck, Detective.
Look at that. An unexpected guest. How very rude, Detective, to come without an invitation.
Thank you.
I know what you're trying to do, Detective. Why work so hard against the inevitable? Why do you care so much about such worthless people? Humans are cruel, sin-ridden beings. They carry out horrible atrocities every day, without a thought to their victims. Defend such miserable creatures. Surely you see they are beyond help. Join us, Detective. We will cleanse the world of its evil and remake it in the glorious image of my father. Start fresh. The world will be better off. We can create the ultimate utopia. Stop wasting your time, Detective. Embrace the purge and accept your fate. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Surprise! Thought I was done for, didn't you? I was lucky. I managed to grab onto a branch before I hit the ground. It slowed my fall and I landed on the beanstalk. Good thing you fixed the aircraft earlier. Otherwise, I couldn't have made it back up here.
Saw Emma?
How is she?
Detective, I'm going to look for Emma. You should try to find the navigation room. If we can just move the Sky Kingdom towards a deserted area, the town will be safe.
Thank you.
Detective, that's a portrait of Emma. She must be around here somewhere. I have to find her.
Do you remember this face, Detective? One of your more well-known cases, I believe. I know everything about you, Detective. Your every thought, every move you'll make.
Detective, that's a portrait of Emma. She must be around here somewhere. I have to find her.
The story begins with a noble-born lady named Emma. Unsatisfied with her mundane lifestyle, she rebelled against her family and trained under the order of the Red Riding Hood sisters. During patrols, Emma saved a young man by the name of Jack, a fortune hunter, with a charming smile and tales of adventure. They fell in love, and she left the sisters for a future with him. Jack had a dream as well, in the form of the elusive kingdom in the sky and the heist of a lifetime. But all his research fell to naught until Emma gave him the magic beans that had been in her family's possession for generations, a secret heirloom connected to the kingdom. But the kingdom proved to be as treacherous as it was bountiful. Emma found herself abandoned by the man she loved, and at the mercy of the king and three princes of the kingdom. Unexpectedly, the king claimed Emma as his descendant, proven by her possession of the magic beans. He treated her like a daughter, but Emma soon realized the king had been bewitched to set upon a nefarious path that would destroy the world. Emma knew she would need help to stop the king. She sabotaged the floating kingdom, exposing its location, and hoped it would alert the attention of the Fairytale Detective before the island's destruction went too far.
Great job, Detective. You got the bolide shard. Hand me the Queen's ring. I'll help you open the box.
No, Detective. He's an imposter. He's trying to trick you.
I've heard rumors that Prince Julian is a shapeshifter. That's a handy trick for fooling people, isn't it? I'm sure you can tell that I'm the real Jack, can't you, Detective?
At last, the Queen's ring. Thank you, Detective. What would we do without you?
When your miscreant little friend stole off with the ring, we thought it was gone forever. Now the power of the shard can be unleashed, and the world will be a blank canvas for us to paint over.
Quick, head to the castle. Go! We need to get that ring back, Detective. Come on, Detective.
Coward. You turned your back on us. You left us here to die. You left me. I will never forgive you for that.
Detective, I must tell you the truth about my past. 10 years ago, when the three princes and the Mad King overpowered us, my friends began to fall and I ran. I thought Emma was behind me. Chopped down the beanstalk so the princess couldn't follow me. And when I realized I was alone, it was too late. Emma's right. I was a coward. I've realized that Emma is more important to me than any treasure in the world. How can I get her to forgive me? Emma, please let me explain.
Get away from me! You fixed the castle, Detective. This is wonderful news. Now we can look for the vault key. The vault key is hidden in Prince Leonard's tower somewhere. We should look for it there.
Thank you.
Once upon a time, a miller boasted his daughter could spin wheat into gold. The king demanded a demonstration, but the miller's daughter had no such skill. Knowing the dawn would bring her death, the daughter wept bitterly. Suddenly, an imp appeared before her and offered to spin the wheat in return for her firstborn child. The daughter agreed. Delighted, the king married her the next day. Their first child soon followed, and for a while, all was well. But one day, the imp reappeared, demanding what had been promised to him. The king and queen pleaded with the imp for mercy, so he proposed that if they could guess his name in 3 days' time, he would release their daughter from the promise. The king guessed rashly and was cursed. But with the help of a tiny messenger, the queen learned the imp's true name was Rumpelstiltskin. Foiled, the imp tried to leave, but the king had other plans. The king imprisoned the imp, forcing him to spin out gold every day. Soon, his kingdom grew rich beyond his wildest dreams, but the king's insatiable desire for gold would soon be his downfall. There was once a wealthy king who was a fanatical collector of valuable treasures. One day, he heard that an old crone had 3 unique treasures in her possession and paid her a visit. The crone presented to him 3 orphan boys, each imbued with a special talent. She guaranteed their loyalty to the king, so he brought them to his kingdom and appointed them princes. The king's obsession with his fortune pushed him to increasing acts of madness. His subjects fled the kingdom in fear, but the 3 loyal princes remained by the king's side. It was on the deserted kingdom that the princes came of age and into their talents. The eldest prince, Leonard, grew to a mighty warrior with a quick temper and a love of battle. The second prince, Julian, was the king's closest confidant, a hedonist and shapeshifter, taking different appearances as he pleased. The youngest prince, Hugh, was an avid scholar. Pursuant of all knowledge, he developed magic beans that allowed them to live unnaturally long lives. The 3 were united in only one cause, to obey the king's whims. Their mindless devotion to the king made them a most fearsome foe to those who would cross him.
The king believes that the queen wished to purge the world of its ugliness. It's no excuse, but he thinks he is honoring her wishes. I've been trying to stop the king for years, but without success, I'm afraid.
Thank you.
Emma, how could you betray us like this?
Look out!
Jack!
I'm fine. It's just a scratch.
It's Prince Julian. He tricked us. Where's the king?
Detective, we have to stop him.
Has unleashed the Bolite Shard. What do we do now?
There was once a young lad named Jack, outraged by the poverty he saw plague friends and family while the rich grew richer. Jack picked fat pockets and shared his spoils with all. Soon, Jack made his way into the world of treasure hunting with a group of like-minded friends, eager to expand his efforts to help the poor. It was during their travels that Jack heard of the legend of a kingdom in the sky. With the help of his fiancée, Emma, he acquired the magic beans that grew into a giant beanstalk. At the top, Jack and his friends found the lost kingdom. But in the midst of a raid, they fell under the attack of three powerful guardians. At the sudden onslaught, Jack fled to the ground and chopped the beanstalk down. By the time he regained his senses, Jack realized that Emma and his friends were now trapped. Racked with guilt, Jack resided in a small cottage by the beanstalk stump for years, desperately searching for a way to rescue them. Little did he know, one day his efforts would set a terrible plot's wheels in motion once again.
No one can stop me now. The world shall be cleansed and made anew. My queen will be proud of me.
Once upon a time, there was a poor but honorable king who was determined to rebuild his kingdom's fortune. One day, his appetite for gold suddenly grew insatiable. The queen, in despair of his greed, took their daughter in hand and left him. The king suffered many lonely years without them, but his obsession with treasure only flourished. One day, a strange witch came to sell him the most valuable treasure in the world. And it was from this witch that the king learned of his beloved queen's death and her most unexpected final wish, that the world be purged and remade into one of beauty and peace. The grieving king vowed to honor her memory with the sacrifice of his greatest treasure. He decided to unleash the shard on the day a meteor shower would rain closest to the earth, a rare occurrence that happened only once every millennium. To protect the rest of his treasure, the king used magic to raise his kingdom into the sky. Though magic ensured the king's long life, his plans were thwarted by a petty thief named Jack, who had unwittingly stolen the key that would unleash the treasure. Though Jack escaped, the rest of his gang was left behind, and there was one woman who reminded the king very much of his beloved queen and their young daughter.
My family when they needed me. And I see now, nothing I do will amend that. But I can still do what's right for you. Do you think my queen would welcome me now?
No, 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 no! Why? Why did it have to end this way?
The king left Emma the ring so we could stop the bolide shard. Take the ring. Emma needs me here.
Dear Emma, if you see this, that means I have failed, and I am grateful for the part you played in that. A part of me realizes I have gone too far, but all the time I have spent, all that hope, I would give anything to have my family back by my side. I turned a deaf ear to your pleas, but I know you are a smart, courageous girl, and you will think of a way to stop me. I regret that such a large burden was placed on your shoulders. I can only hope that I was stopped in time. Thank you.
Thank you, Detective. You saved us all. Emma, the King wanted you to live. He wanted you to be happy.
The Sky Kingdom was destroyed by the great power of the Bolide Shard. With the trusty aircraft, Jack, Emma, and the detective were able to escape unscathed. The King was reunited with his family, with the realization of what true happiness meant. And Jack and Emma rediscovered a treasure worth more than gold. Love. Thanks to the great fairy tale detective, the world was safe once again. Until the next time.